Welcome to Melodies in Mind, the happiest show on earth. You are being summoned into the songs of the spirit of social concern. So relax, kick back, and join the harmony. Every week, we bring three featured guests who share their music in an interview, starting at 8 p.m. Then, they come together for a full hour song circle at 9. Now, come with me and let us meet today's featured guest, shall we?
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Ryan Fletcher. I'm the host of Melodies of Mind, a radio show that happens at Simon Fraser University every Tuesday night, 8 to 10 p.m. And today we're here at the Burnaby Village Museum, and we're going to have a episode happen right here. It'll be recorded and then played tomorrow night on the air on 90.1 FM. So if you're in the audience and you say something really loud, you can hear yourself on the radio tomorrow night. Well, we got three booked musicians here that are going to be playing as part of the show, as normally happens on the show. The station is 90.1 FM. CJSF. It's also on the internet, www.cjsf.ca. So our first performer will be Ross Fairbairn. I'm going to be doing three 20-minute interviews with music, and then the second hour, going from 3 to 4, will be continuous music. And so put your hands together, and then apart and together in a clapping motion for Ross Fairbairn.
Stay alive.
Ross Christopher Faber. So Ross, tell us a bit about yourself. Where are you from?
Originally born and raised in Richmond, British Columbia. Spent the first 30 years of my life there. Then did a quick tour of all the burbs. You know, did some time in Coquitlam, then lived on a farm in Delta. Then
what were you arrested for?
Several different things, actually. I got one of those punch cards. My 10th arrest is actually going to be free.
All right, awesome. So I know you to be one of the most active musicians in Vancouver. Maybe you can tell us a bit. You do your solo thing. What are some other projects you're involved in?
It ranges quite a bit. I play bass for a few different people. There's an act called the Pernell Reichert Band, and we play all across Canada. So if you ever see the name Pernell Reichert on a poster, go see him play. I'll likely be on the bass with him. That's a three-piece kind of alt country, roots rock. Then the same three guys, me, Pernell, and Tom, the drummer, we have another group called East Van Grass. And that's the same three of us. We just play old blues tunes in that particular configuration.
So in that first song was?
Well, we don't actually play that song in that group, which is strange.
I see.
I wrote a song about the group that we don't perform in the group.
I see. It helps people make connect the dots.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Ross Fairbairn plays a song called East Van Grass.
Exactly.
He must be a member of the band.
Right.
Yeah. So East Van Grass should write a song called Ross Christopher Fairbairn. So people can connect the dots that way.
Yeah, I can see that sort of cross-marketing and whatnot.
Yeah, absolutely. Help people locate their musician and band. And
precisely.
Yep, I like it.
All right, well, let's have another tune here from Ross.
All right. Here's one about... Sorry, I'm a little boomy today.
Be a note that I play a lot in this song.
Okay.
That was the first one.
This is a little tune about that guy. Everybody knows that guy. He's the one you lose touch of after school or after college or after a significant portion of your life. He just disappears one day. And I reckon could be what happened to that guy. Tuesday was good enough for him. Never rabbi day to risk life and limb. Diamonds are such a lovely sin. Regardless of the punishment, he'll never want to pack it in. Map and tools all ready to go. One last replay, an off-duty big show. Back alleys, empty streets. No shining lights and nimble on his feet. As for the cops, yes, I know they knew he did it. And they followed him down all the way to Nesbitt. Took the last train and the midnight ferry. But they'll never find him, you see, he changed his name to Barry. Can't see him coming cause he's quicker than you think. See him in the distance, but now well quickly shrink. All his victims left in a daze. Determination practice is all that it takes. Lightning breaks up a quiet attack. Through the shadows, on his way round back. Laser trips and a safe with no knob. Both are down and still it's getting raw. Hey! As for the cops, yes, I know they knew he did it. And they followed him down all the way to Nesbitt. Took the last train and the midnight ferry. But they'll never find him, yes, see, he changed his name to Barry. One day he will turn a leaf a different way. Settle down, start again, and finally get to stay. Tempting as it seems, he never really ever tried. Each time was the grand finale, but he always lied. Smiling face with a subterfuge. Not so friendly when all that's left is shoes. Everyone's equal, gonna get the chance. Black hot items found barely even had to glance. Never dull moments, living on the edge. Hope to catch a break standing on a lonely ledge. If a tree or in a bush when you pass, dressed as a postman or a sweet old Irish lass. As for the cops, yes, I know they knew he did it. And they followed him down
all the way to Nesbitt. The last train and the midnight ferry. But they'll never find him, you see, he changes into Barry. Hey. That's Ross Christopher Fairbairn. And we are, for those of you listening on the radio, we are at Burnaby Village Museum today, doing a live episode with a very nice atmosphere here of people looking around at the fall fair that's happening at the museum, and lots of people standing around, lots of little people out there, some trying to break security and get on the stage and perform on their own. I contact me next time, and we'll see if you fit the bill. All right. And so it's really wonderful. Do you have any albums out?
Well, I do. I actually have several albums out. My most current one is called What You Just Heard. And it's a concept album. Basically, the concept is, if you've seen me live perform, it's probably what you just heard. It's a bunch of me, and it's me and an acoustic guitar in a basement. I thought it was a fairly accurate representation of what I do as a solo musician. So it's okay. What you just heard, and it comes in multiple colors. I wrote all the songs, produced all of the recordings. I printed off all the labels myself. I did all the artwork, and it's a fantastic. It's right down there. I don't know. This is it. Radio isn't the most visual of mediums, but it is down there. You can visualize me pointing at it, and the people at the museum. Yeah. You can pick your own color. There's several. And actually, just as a quick point, for anyone listening to this on the radio, don't come running down to the museum right now.
Yeah, that's right. That's a good point. this is happening yesterday. It's a little it's a little bit of a time experiment here. So yeah, if you're listening, you'll be listening Tuesday night, at least in the Vancouver broadcast, but this is happening Monday afternoon on Labor Day.
I suppose if you've already run down, just keep looking. We're probably there somewhere.
We are in a museum, so they could try and preserve it. So that it'll still be there by the time you...
Well, yeah, this will be preserved online for basically infinity.
That's right, yes.
The online...
As all things are.
Google has us now.
Yes.
Oh, dear.
Google owns me.
Yeah.
They own 90% of everything I've ever said to anybody, I think.
Okay, so moving right along.
Yeah.
We'll have another song from Ross Christopher Fairbairn. Satisfaction. Once again, when I pay a nightmare of heaven,
lights, guns in action. Take that last turn quickly, certain needs, they must be met. What is it that grates me? Not all that easy to forget. Growling shadows with one teeth, tighten up and hard to breathe. Smell the fear attack and stance, turn and make that homeward dash light. Gonna be lights, guns in action. Gonna be lights, guns in action. Gonna be lights, guns in action. Someone stole the ocean right from off of our beach. Way up in the distance, oh, go grab all your flashlights. There's a lesson we all must teach. On the way we're finding clues, little tails and soggy shoes. Rolling lines, that final crush, something that we all can touch. Lights, guns in action. Gonna be lights, guns in action. Gonna be lights, guns in action. Gonna be lights, guns in action. But the same each time, always find a different finding and then a satisfaction. Once again, what will it be? A nightmare of heavenly or lights, guns in action.
And are you on the internet?
I most certainly am, Ryan.
You can find me and everything I do online at stompyourfoot.com. And that's S-T-O-M-P, like stomp. And then your is Y-E-R. Y-E-R. Your. There we go, precisely. Foot, F-O-O-T.com. Stompyourfoot.com. That's me.
All right, so if you want to check out more. And we'll get one more tune out of you, Ross, right, and then we'll move along to Shunpikers. We're next.
This is a love song. Or it's a song about being in love, or a song about love. I find that the more I embrace my singer-songwriterness, the more I realize my relationship seemed to last about three verses and a chorus.
The last smoke like a pool cue. I think to recall my joke. One more embrace in the moonlight. Remembering each one from before. In the moment, thinking about chapters ahead of us. I know I'm writing today's page. Thumbing through the prologue, cause it's fun to remember her. On June 19th, 2/14, the 2010 car free day. Door to door and dust in a rearview. Room to room and all up their new charms. roof to roof with everyone else that's under.
And it's only once I feel your heartbeat that I know when I am as the mighty Fraser claims the first of four phones. It's rare an occurrence, my chariot awaits us. Take you back to your throne. Traffic lights tire of keeping us waiting. Drifting between the thoughts, spill a few drops to christen a journey. A bon voyage to what we now have got. Door to door and dust in a rearview mirror. Room to room and all up their new charge. Roof to roof with everyone else that's under. Yet it's only once I feel your heartbeat that I know when I am home. From near to slumber, I blink to keep my gaze, waiting for that final jostle. Watching you dream as the last thing of my day. Door to door and dust and a rearview mirror. Room to room and all up their new charm. Roof to roof with everyone else that's under. Yet it's only once I feel your heartbeat, that I know when I am home.
Alright, that's Russ Faber. And we'll have the Sunpipers. Well, just a reminder, if you're listening on the radio, this is coming to you from Burnaby Village Museum on a different day than when you're listening to this. It's been recorded for you, so you can catch the magic that happens on this day, just in case you're not here. But there are plenty of people here. I'm happy to see lots of people around ready to hear the Shunpikers, who are now going to have their first song for you. Thank you. The Shunpikers. So, first of all, what is a Shunpiker?
Well, the short version of the answer to that question is Shunpiker is an old term that referred to people who would avoid toll pikes, turnpikes. In medieval times, in England and also in North America and the United States for a time, people would own roads, and so they would have a pike over that road, and you'd have to pay them in order to proceed down their road. And so there were those like us who would avoid those tolls and choose the back roads. And this term has come to mean nowadays those who take the road less traveled, I suppose.
Wonderful. And we have a fairly unique instrument here on it. It's not exactly guitar. Can you tell us a bit about what that is?
Yes, Ryan, my main instrument is the Irish bouzouki, and it's a sort of a member of both the lute family and the mandolin family. Usually you'll see it with a big long neck and a big giant mandolin body. This is an even weirder animal in that it marries the bouzouki with a guitar body. It's a fairly new Irish traditional instrument, and it's actually kind of got into a whole lot of different folk music and stuff since then. It kind of came to being in the early 60s when some Irish traditional players brought the Greek bouzouki into Irish music and kind of changed its shape and its sound and its tuning to suit the Irish trad tune. So it's coincidentally as old as me, so I think we were made for one another.
That sounds like it. All right, so we'll have another song from the Shunpikers.
I thought I knew what I was doing. I was wrong. Mistakes I've made and lived to tell all the better song. I knew the river wide and deep, her banks were very when you land.
All right, so this is the Shunpikers, and do you have any albums out?
We got a CD here with us that we did just a little while ago called Making Tracks, and that's got 10 tunes on there spanning our Celtic and our bluegrass repertoire. And for those of you that are lucky enough to be here today, we have a special sale on CDs, only $5. When you compare that to an ice cream cone or a fish and chips, it's not a bad deal. Anyway, if you'd like to take a CD home with you, talk to us afterwards.
I hear it goes well with ice cream.
I think so. Delicious.
Now, at the museum, you might not be familiar with the CD. It's like a phonograph, but it's gone ahead a little bit. It's actually, you need a special player, a CD player, that will be available in about 30 or 40 years from the time period we're in here.
We're working on it.
Yeah, but look for it in about 30 or 40 years, and it'll be there. All right, so we're going to have another song here from the Shunpikers.
Okay, this is a couple of tunes by Irish banjo player, popularized by bouzouki player from a band called Alton from Ireland, Kieran Curran. And this goes by Kieran's Capers. A couple of fiddle tunes here for you, rendered on the bouzouki. Thank you.
Shunpikers. The Shunpikers. And do you have a website for those of us that have...
Best way to find the Shunpikers is on Facebook. S-H-U-N-P-I-K-E-R-S. You'll find us there.
All right. Well, thank you very much, Shunpikers. So we'll give John a little time to set up here, and while he does, I want to tell you a bit about the show. So now I know we're at a museum, so I should explain the website. You shouldn't be looking at spider webs. It's not a spider thing. In the future, there will be the internet, and it'll take a while. It'll come around 1998. So we're in 1925. Here's that's it'll happen in about. It's about more like 95, I think, actually. About 70 years, and then you could do the internet thing. But if you're listening on radio, then it's there for you right now. And there's a website for the radio show, www.melodiesinmind.com. And I chose that website because the show is called Melodies in Mind. .com is... I don't... Maybe you know, you're a web guy. What's .com say?
I have no idea.
Yeah. Anyway, I always wanted to get a website called calm.com and just be the most relaxing website, calm.com. So the radio show airs on every week, and it's syndicated. Actually, this hour here, this opening hour, is syndicated. It's on 10 other stations across the country. So this will be aired across the country in Canada. So 10 other stations are picking up the show and broadcasting it at various times across the country. And so there's a lot more pressure on John Welsh than he even knew. And we're going to have our first song from John Welsh right now.
Yeah, might as well.
This is a song I wrote in Spanish. This one's called Mexicana.
Muévete en la cintura, pésame mi amor. Muévete en la cintura, quiero sentir tu calor. Quiero una mexicana, vámonos a México. Ve conmigo, señorita, el amor es lo que busco. Lo que busco. Ya sabrás que aquí hace mucho frío y ya no lo puedo aguantar. Oh. Ya sabrás que aquí hace mucho frío, por eso me voy a otra parte. Yo quiero una brasileña, ella sabe.
John Welsh. So, you're not Spanish, are you?
No, I'm not.
So why do you have a Spanish song?
Okay, well, I actually, when I was in university, I went down to Guatemala and spent the time on an exchange program there and learned to speak fluent Spanish. And so when I came back to this area, I just kept it up through friends and things like that and started singing some songs in Spanish. So part of my music involves songs in Spanish and English.
For those of us who don't speak Spanish, would we be worried about what's in your lyrics?
No, I don't think so. You're okay.
Okay. So tell us a bit about yourself. So what part of the world are you from?
Well, I was actually originally born in Ontario, Southern Ontario. My family is from the UK, so they moved out here. We moved out here to BC when I was younger, and then we moved around a lot when I was a kid, and we went back to England. And so I'm used to traveling a lot, moving a lot, so a lot of my music is inspired by being on the road, that kind of thing.
All right. And I have another tune here from John Welsh.
What I'm going to play you, this one is a song I wrote in St. John's, Newfoundland. It's on my new EP, which Ryan now has a copy of. It's called the Newfoundland Song. So sing along when you get the hang of it. Here we go.
You brought a piece of fabric and a baby boutique. You made a sail for fashion and love a flow sheet. You match your kitchen cupboards, the orange, white, and green. She wore across the country the finest shirt you've ever seen. I met her at a party in the town of Old St. John's. She was playing fiddle to some old sailor songs. I picked up my guitar and I began to sing along. We stayed there drinking all night until the break of dawn. Hey! Down a water street, and those Newfoundlanders made me down a triple shot of screech. But if you're ever in trouble, then I'll be there to lend a hand in that windy, foggy place where the ocean meets the land. Hey! Through the old town under the summer stars, down winding cobble streets and past the noisy bars. We went out to the lighthouse along the sand and stones and sang this song out to the sea to call the sailor song. Hey! Fabric down at the boutique, and then a self a fine shirt out of a floral sheet. And it matched your kitchen cupboards, orange, white, and green. She wore across the country the finest shirt you've ever seen. Hey!
John Welsh. So you have this album On the Road. Tell us a bit about this.
Oh, okay. Well, that's a collection of songs I just released a couple months ago. And actually, the title track was we just did a video for it. Released a video with a 79 Volkswagen bus and features me and some members of the band traveling across BC. And that's done really well for us. Lots of people have been sharing it. I guess they like the band, the tune, and all that sort of
thing. On YouTube? Or
that's on YouTube, yeah. If you look up John Welsh on the road, you'll see that.
How do you spell John?
J-O-H-N.
How do you spell Welsh?
W-E-L-S-H.
Okay.
Yes.
I already know. It's for the audience.
Yeah, fair enough.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great. I just like to make sure. All right, and do you have a website? You have the YouTube, you must have a website too?
Yeah, it's johnwelshmusic.ca. You can find out where I'm playing shows. I'm playing actually this Saturday evening in New West with my full band.
Oh, yes. At the Heritage?
At Frankie G's.
Frankie G's, okay. Yes. All right, and so we'll have one more tune from John Welsh. I'm going to play the title track of the album. This one's called On the Road.
Where do we go now? Is this where you want to be? I'm on the road now. I'm trying to lose you. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, no, no, no. Does he love me? I don't know anymore. Is it over? Right now, I'm not too sure. Leaving home now. In the early, early morning, got a feeling. I've been here before.
If you're listening on the syndicated stations across the country, the show ends here, I'm afraid. But if you want to hear what happens after this, you can go to the website, melodiesofmind.com, and you can stream the second hour. But if you're listening locally in the greater Vancouver area, including Burnaby Village Museum, where we are live right now, then the show continues.
La, 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 la. La 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 la.
Thank you for listening to Melodies in Mind. It is my hope that you have had at least half as much fun as we did in putting this show together. It's a total joy to be bringing you the best in folk music every week. So thanks for checking out the show, and be sure to tell your friends, and tune in again next week, 8 to 10 p.m. And remember, without a tune in your head, you are seriously misled. Oh, and if you have any comments, email melodiesinmind@gmail.com.